We know that this legislation, when it finally gets to Governor Shapiro's desk and is signed into law, is going to provide long-needed protections for our community. And like I said, as a queer woman, this issue is so incredibly personal to me. And so the passage of this act in the House is yet another step to ensuring that every Pennsylvanian is treated with dignity and respect. Like my co-chair said, we heard a lot of misrepresentations on the floor today. And so I just want to echo again that this bill is as simple as it is substantive. It only extends protections that are already granted to individuals on the basis of other categories, and it creates no new rights, despite the misconceptions that some seem to hold. Furthermore, both Rep. Kenyatta and I will say that we did not get everything we wanted in this bill. This bill was amended in committee in a way that, frankly, ensures the bill doesn't go as far as we wanted it to. And I know we're not going to stop fighting for additional protections for our community. It's not fair that we're treated differently than other categories that are already protected here. But that's the legislative process. You negotiate, you work together, and like my colleague, I am grateful for the bipartisan support of this legislation, which I know is going to be extended in the state Senate, though not without hard work and difficult conversations. And I'm looking forward to having many of those conversations with our colleagues on the other side of this building. We know that most Pennsylvanians believe our Commonwealth is better when it is fairer. HB 300 is going to ensure a fairer and more equal future for all of us. And today, that is what we are celebrating.